Origin 2 on its way. Queensland now got their own injury concerns with Selwyn Cobbo. He's out. This is going to be a game where most of the, you know, so many of the good players are not playing.
It's becoming a war of attrition, isn't it? Obviously, Queensland with a 1-0 lead. Billy Slater came out and named his side today. Now, three changes for them due to injury. You mentioned Selwyn Cobbo. That was a surprise. There are suggestions that if the Broncos had had to play this weekend, they've got the bye, he would have been able to. So Queensland have obviously decided he's not ready. They brought Xavier Coates in. Who knows what Origin's all about? He's played six times before. He is a quality winger. That's fine. Obviously, Tom Gilbert and Jai Arrow are the other outs for Queensland, both through injury. Jeremiah Nanai comes in, knows what it's about, would have been there in game one if not for suspension. And Mo Fodawaker from the Titans as well, he comes into the side. Queensland have just fixed the injury problems they have. New South Wales will announce their team reportedly at 11 a.m. tomorrow. This is the interesting one, though. They need to replace Nathan Cleary and Api Korosau, their half and their hooker, through injury. It would appear what Mitch Moses did today for the Parramatta Eels will be enough to get him that seven spot. That's what the reports are suggesting. And it looks like South's Damien Cook will come in at hooker. But then Freddie looks like he's going to make some unforced changes, not through injury, as well, with Tevita Pangai Jr., Hudson Young and Nico Hines all to be dropped. And the changes that they'll make to that side, it looks like Reece Robson from the Cowboys might get a start and Spencer Lienu coming in from the Panthers as well. So there is some chopping and changing. But if you're a New South Wales supporter, the good news is Latrell Mitchell, who was a massive out on the eve of game one in Adelaide, looks set to be named tomorrow for the Blues.